Hi, I'm Callie King from CRK Training, and I'm here today with Jochen Schleese from Schleese Saddlery. Jochen Schleese is a certified master saddler and master saddle fitter, as well as owner of Schleese Saddlery, a company based in Canada. Jochen is also author of the book Suffering in Silence. Jochen doesn't just fit and sell saddles, he is an educator on the importance of saddle fit for both horse and rider, and the dangers posed by saddles that do not fit correctly. His company specializes in saddles made for women, which is what I would like to focus on in our interview today, how the fit of the saddle affects the health and the balance of the rider. So, first, thank you for your time in answering my questions.
You're welcome.
And the first question that I would like to ask is, why is this important and why do saddles need to be different for women?
Well, in no other sport than in riding is where we using our pelvis as much. And when we look at skeleton in the ground, the only way we can tell this was a male or a female is on the skeleton. So there's a huge difference in the pelvis of the skeleton between the male and the female. Yes, the burst channel, but it's also the hip socket, the seat bone placement, the balancing axis. And what makes it so interesting is that before it was never really paid attention to it, because for 4,500 years, men made saddles for men. Mm-hmm. And today still most guys make saddles. Mm-hmm. And one of the big authors I quote a lot is Xenophon. He talks about how you can train our horse using our seat, our balance. Mm-hmm. And when I stand like this with a little bit bent knee, and I pretend I have my hands here, that's a balance stand. Mm-hmm. Now when I use this stand and just sit on the horse, mm-hmm. now nothing, I'm not falling like on my chair seat or like I'm driving my car. Mm-hmm. If I'm standing just like that, the pelvis shouldn't tilt. Mm-hmm. Also known the riding seat is the standing seat, it's because the pelvis is just as if you stand. Now it's pretty easy for guys because a pelvis axis on the male pelvis is in the middle. I brought a male pelvis here, and the male pelvis, when I say pelvis axis, which means the center of the hip socket right here, mm-hmm. if I look from the bottom, it's right in the middle. So if I'm sitting on it, in other words, when a male sits on the horse, it's very easy to balance. I look sideways through the camera here, very easy for a guy to balance on the saddle. Mm-hmm. When I bring my seat bones to the horse, you can see how this pelvis, this vertebrae is falling back. This is actually how the pelvis is in our back. You can see how straight that is? Mm-hmm. So we can do this pelvis tilt. Mm-hmm. So again, for 4,500 years, no problem. And as we know, 90% of all our clients are now women, mm-hmm. more in this industry than ever in history. Now the women's pelvis, you can see here on the hip socket, this little shelf and this little opening here. Mm-hmm. Now we don't have this. We don't have as many hip problems as some riders have.
Yeah.
And you also notice there's a seat bone here, it goes a little forward and then it goes up. Mm-hmm. See that? This is where the underwear line comes through. Mm-hmm. So when we, our saddle makers got the first complaint, oh, it rubs me where my underwear is, or here on this other saddle, we ask the person, would you mind get off the saddle? And then the saddler sits on.
Yeah.
We don't feel it because we don't have this bone.
Yeah.
Now, if I'm making her sit straight, so in other words, that the vertebrae is more forward, you will notice that the pubic symphysis is now sitting right on top of that wood piece. Mm-hmm. Now, horses have more with us than this. Mm-hmm. So in order to avoid the with us against the pubic symphysis, naturally, without even thinking, what do you think you do? You're leaning back, mm-hmm. just to protect yourself.
Yeah.
Now look at the back, how far you lean back. Mm-hmm. So the first thing I learned as a saddle maker, if I'm looking at a tree, the wood tree I have over there, the wood tree here is built, it has metal plates so the saddle doesn't crush, stirrup bar, mm-hmm. and then a curve is built and you see all the different foam pieces. Mm-hmm. I always rip on it to show people, see this little leather piece where it's putting on?
Mm-hmm.
All that is done, all this is done in order to form comfort. Mm-hmm. And the first thing what I was taught, 78, was when you come to a foaming, make this very pointy. So a male rider wants that very pointy in the front. Why? Mm-hmm. Well, without sounding too rude, we don't want to fall on our own parts. Mm-hmm. So they most of the time go to one side or the other side. Mm-hmm. Now, the female parts, you can't put them left or right like on the male. So if I'm looking at a male saddle, how can I recognize, I'd like to buy a saddle. Is this a male or female? It's actually very, very visual.
Okay.
Right? So I have two saddles here. One is a male saddle. You can see how the seam is narrow. Mm-hmm. Okay, and it comes pointy up. So this is what's classified as a typical male saddle. Mm-hmm. Because we don't have wide seat bones like ladies or girls have for mm-hmm. weight-bearing, for birth channel. We don't want this here too wide. So for all these years, we have made saddles which are pretty narrow here, very pointy here, and quite wide here. The reason why we like it wide is because we have narrow hips, but the femur goes straight down. We have a lot of space between our upper inner thigh because our thigh is oval.
Yeah.
Okay, there's a lot of space. So I need to have that filled out. So when I sit in the saddle, I can feel how I have even contact all the way from one side down the other side. Mm-hmm. I can do my pelvis tilt without any problem. I feel comfortable mm-hmm. and it carries me wide. Now if I ask Julia to hop on this saddle, and Julia, do you mind hopping on this saddle? So this is what's been built for many, many years. So many riders now are female riders. And I don't instruct anymore or judge anymore. But the first thing I'm trying to get, remember what I said in the beginning, I want to have that shoulder, hips, and heels alignment. Mm-hmm. And if I look at my plumb line, you will see if I'm going to put a tape here, shoulder, hips, and heels, you can see how this is not even close to a heel. Mm-hmm. So as an instructor, I would say, come on, let's bring your leg back. Do you mind if I'm just going to put your legs back? Then I notice this curve here. Says, why does she has this funny curve here? So I says, okay, you're not doing it right. Okay, so then I'm trying to force her body. So with permission, I ask to lift up the leg, grab her hamstring, and trying to pull her muscle, and I still have that curve there. Mm-hmm. Now, we have the muscle more in the back. The guys have the thigh more oval, and ladies have hips, and the femur comes out, goes in, and then down, mm-hmm. more cone shape. And the muscle's more in the inside. So girls have less space. So why would I like to have a saddle what's too wide here? Mm-hmm. The guys like it. Again, 4,500 years we made them like this. This would absolutely kill the hips and the knees. And it's really interesting to see that doctors write books about it, that this hip and knee damage can come actually from saddles. So if I'm going to ask you to step down and I'm going to sit here in a female saddle, the first thing you can notice when you look at a female saddle is the seaming is much wider. So of course your mind goes, wow, that's wide, that hurts my hip even more. Mm-hmm. Now this is where these seat bones were, what I was showing you earlier. This is where the underwear line is, what we don't have as a male. But what's interesting about this is right down here, behind the stirrup bar, that's where the tree is really cut out. Mm-hmm. So if Julia can sit on this one here, it has a different seaming. The form is, and we can see without me playing on her thigh, pulling it back, and compare that again to my plumb line, I can see immediately, are you forcing your leg back or is this natural?
It feels great.
It feels great.
This is okay. Comfortable.
Shoulder, hips, and heels is one line. Mm-hmm. So if you want to hop off, thank you very much. So the main difference is, if I have such a difference in the pelvises, mm-hmm. male, female, then I can say, as a manufacturer, rider, trainer, salesperson, saddle fitter, anybody who is in this industry, mm-hmm. do I would like to force bones around metal and wood and plastic, mm-hmm. what just doesn't fit? Or will I say, it worked for 4,500 years. Now the majority of people who ride have a birth channel, mm-hmm. women, and the bone structure is just different. Can you imagine that there's actually some people who say, there can't be such a difference? Or they say, the women wouldn't do so good if it would be such a problem. Mm-hmm. One of my favorite stories is that was an older lady, she says, well, today's people don't know how to ride, that's the problem. I learned to ride. Mm-hmm. I learned by the old masters, and I know, and I can ride in any saddle. Now this lady, she couldn't be more than 50, 55 years old. You know what her body looked like? She literally stand, that's how she walked, that's her position. And if I'm walking like this, mm-hmm. right, I deform my body. It's kind of like the old days when the Chinese wanted the women's feet so narrow and mm-hmm. so small. Have you ever heard about the story mm-hmm. in the 1600s? Or I don't know, it was 14 or 1600s, and they deformed the feet because they wanted that narrowness. So. If I'm, again, listened to biomechanics or veterinarians or doctors who say, this is how our body works. So if you use your four curves in your body, you're mm-hmm. soft in your ankle, where you can absorb the shock, you can independently give the aids here. Mm-hmm. Why would you struggle something out of plastic and metal? Mm-hmm. My strong belief is it's all about the money. Because there is massive amount of saddles made and they sit in the store and they need to be sold. Mm-hmm. Have you ever heard about marketing in terms of this person wears this logo and everybody runs and wants that?
Yes.
In saddle industry it's just the same. And it works very well, mm-hmm. but you know who suffers the most?
Probably the horse.
Absolutely. Now when we had Julia sitting in here, all the weight goes to the back. You can stuff, you can massage, you can put gel pads, foam pads, it doesn't matter. Because if I have a neutral, a proper position, a pliable seat where I can give the aids, I have four curves in my back, which are my shock absorption, and I got my hip, my knee, my ankle. Mm-hmm. So I become half my weight, and I can implement and connect to my horse. Mm-hmm. If I already sitting in this lock position, now my head bobs, or my knee comes up, or I'm gripping with the thigh just to stay with him.
Yeah.
Now I'm becoming this twice as heavy jackhammer. And it doesn't matter how expensive or cheap the saddle is,
yeah.
how thick or thin the foam is,
yep.
the horse will get that feel. Does that make sense?
It does make sense. One question that I had, how much does it vary on an individual basis for men or women with just the size of our pelvis, basically?
Right. We have sometimes people say, well, how come I can ride in a male saddle and how come I can ride in the female saddle? I mean, it's the same with pants. Mm-hmm. You know, the jeans are totally different cut for a guy than for a girl. But there's one or the other female who says, hey, I like that pants, it works. I can wear male pants much better than female pants.
Yeah.
Right, you heard that before?
Yep.
But in the majority, you have women mm-hmm. who like the jeans where they're cut more for the female.
Yeah.
Right. What do they variety here? Just like for guys, they come in different sizes, and it's if I say standard, you have a wider seam here, a wider seam here, and then really narrow underneath where your thigh was, where I grabbed Julia's thigh and rolled it back.
Yeah.
Okay. So that's standard, but that doesn't mean there's one or the other lady. Like you, for example, you have hips, but you're petite, you don't have really wide hips. Mm-hmm. You might be happy with a medium seat here, mm-hmm. okay? But your pelvis has more lordosis than a male. In other words, your lower back has a little bit more of an arch. Mm-hmm. That doesn't mean that all ladies are like that, but some could be straight. Yeah. So more lordosis you have, so more curvature you have in the lower back, guess what that does to your pubic symphysis or the bones would rub in the front.
Yeah.
Right? So you could have actually, for one or the other, ladies, just as yourself, mm-hmm. a little bit narrow here, but much softer here, and keep that wide.
Okay.
Does that make sense?
Yeah.
Okay. So that is their pretty much the main changes.
Okay.
Just like in horses, I don't like to generalize.
Yep.
And if I have to say what are the main differences between male and female pelvises, male pelvis balance axis is started in the middle, mm-hmm. the female is more in the front. Mm-hmm. Tendency falling always back. It's always there. It's just because the way the pelvis is balanced.
Yep.
Where the hip sockets are in relation to the middle part of the pelvis.
Yep.
The pubic symphysis is lower, you have a different hip socket, you have different femurs. And this you can't deny, no matter how tall or small you are. That's the main feature.
Yeah.
And I think that's really what took this industry by storm, and that's why we decided to look after 90% of our clients are female.
Yep.
And that doesn't mean we don't make male saddles.
Mm-hmm.
It's just that more women who ride have a hard time finding something what fits them.
Yeah. Okay. Now, if someone is riding, and I know we kind of saw the chair seat a little bit earlier with Julia, what other either position things that someone struggles with or even pain in like hips or knees,
mm-hmm.
what are kind of some maybe telltale signs that they might be fighting their saddle, not just that they need to learn how to ride better?
Mm-hmm. Yeah, it's actually a very easy trick. When you sit in the saddle, I would always recommend when you try one, put a pair of jeans on it, on a saddle stand. You know those metal ones? They're really, really good. Put them backwards because then that little hump here holds the candle up.
Yep.
So when you sit in that and you can move your pelvis back and forth mm-hmm. without feeling any pressure in the front, that seam from the jeans.
Yes.
Then you can say, when I have my riding breeches on, and which doesn't have the seam,
yep.
I know I'm not getting killed. If you feel
okay.
that seam in the jeans, in the tack shop,
yeah.
don't even think buying it.
Yeah.
Because the tack shop horse will not move.
Mm-hmm.
Doesn't do walk, trot, cant, and for sure doesn't go galloping uphill.
Yeah.
So the first thing, we don't like to talk about it, but we have a lot of sensitivity in our fingertips.
Mm-hmm.
But before we even realize something is rubbing, pinching, hurting, our muscles in our body, our thigh gets tight.
Yeah.
So that is the most common thing you do. And what the first thing you see, knee goes up. So if you struggle with your leg position,
yeah.
most of the time, not just the curvature from front to back, also from left to right, could be a problem.
Okay.
The best advice besides the jeans is, when you try a saddle in the tack shop or on the horse and you do not even feel the saddle,
mm-hmm.
then you know it distributes the pressure right.
Mm-hmm.
Most common other problems you hear a lot is, you get off and says, oh my God, when I ride in the saddle, my back is killing me.
Mm-hmm.
You're using too much back muscle to stay with the position.
Okay.
That is very often when the saddle is too wide in the twist. The twist is not what you see.
Mm-hmm.
The twist is what is between your upper inner thigh, right where my two thumbs are.
Mm-hmm.
And that would be in the saddle in this area.
Okay.
You don't see it. You can't press it. You feel it.
Mm-hmm.
Right? And just like we saw on Julia, that male saddle has a wide twist.
Yeah.
Put in the chair seat.
Yep.
This female has a narrow twist. Her leg fell down.
Mm-hmm.
Yes, they do come in mediums as well. But that's one of the most common problems that females riding in the saddle,
mm-hmm.
what has steel reinforced side bars, and these steel reinforced side bars, you can't break in.
Mm-hmm.
They're there.
Yep.
So that's probably the second most problem.
Okay. I have actually one other question
yes?
I thought of. So I saw this when I was reading your book. This placement of the stirrup bars
mm-hmm.
and the relation of, I guess, leg length
mm-hmm.
between men and women. Could you talk about that a little bit?
Yes. The stirrup leather is positioned or hung to the stirrup bar. And this stirrup bar is directly attached to the front of the gullet plate.
Mm-hmm.
So you can see how this rivets here. It attaches to the metal plate here on the bottom.
Mm-hmm.
And you can see when I put this on, that's where your stirrup leather would be. So when you buy a saddle, right in front here is either the D-ring or one of those nails.
Mm-hmm.
So you can always say, I wonder if I get 2-finger or 3-finger. You can look at that. What's the distance from where the stirrup leather starts, where the D-ring is,
mm-hmm.
or that little nail what some saddle have there.
Yeah.
So here I would say I have 2.5 fingers, or like 2 thick fingers.
Mm-hmm.
A If I look at that underneath, see that?
Uh-huh.
To the D-ring, that's four.
Okay.
See how you can recognize that now?
Yes.
Okay, so in general, the male's lower leg, uh-huh, if you measure it from where the sole starts all the way to the middle of your knee there, uh-huh, is longer than the upper leg on the male.
Okay.
In ladies, if you bend your knees a little bit, uh-huh, and now you put that point, just hold it here to the side. Mm-hmm. Look now from your hip down to your finger, how long that is in relation to the lower part of your leg.
Yeah.
See that?
Yep.
So, does that mean that all the ladies are? Pretty much. Could it be that one or the other lady or guy has it reversed? Absolutely.
Yeah.
Right? So, but in general, you see that the thigh is longer on the lady.
Uh-huh.
You notice when I put this pendulum here, it hangs up front.
Uh-huh.
If I move it back, it hangs further back.
Uh-huh.
Now, if I would like to have a saddle where I can have a rising trot, I don't want to chase my feet, which means the stirrup leather jerks my foot forward,
uh-huh,
because it's a pendulum, right? Now, in order to rise, I got to bring my sternum over my foot, and then I hit the pommel at rising trot. So that's a lot of action.
Yeah.
And that makes the horse very unstable.
Mm-hmm.
Causes a rail in the jumping, too much breathing, too much pulse goes up in the endurance, and in dressage,
mm-hmm,
you constantly change your balance. So instead of chasing your foot, having the stirrup bar placed every inch further back,
mm-hmm,
you now have the stirrup leather hang where your foot is. Your foot is underneath you, and when you rise up rather than forward. You just rise up. And you're very, very quiet, and you're helping the horse to engage and lengthening their steps.
Yeah.
Does that make sense?
Yes, it does.
Yes.
Okay. Very good. Well, again, thank you for your time and answering the questions.
Good.
And the last thing that I'd kind of like to finish with is, if someone is, you know, listening to this and thinking, I need a new saddle,
mm-hmm,
what do you recommend as a good first step? I mean, I know, you know, I've had experience with your company, and I really recommend your company.
Mm-hmm.
What's the best way for someone to find a saddle fitter, you know, to go into the, you gave us some great tips for the tack shop, but if they want to kind of take it a step further,
mm-hmm,
is there a place where they can find a saddle fitter that might be able to help them?
Right. We, together with the German National Riding School in North America, here with the USDF, we're working very close together with the competitive trail riders, Western riders. We get huge support,
mm-hmm,
because what we do, we certify saddle fitter. As a matter of fact, it's not a saddle fitter because it has a nasty slang of saddle salespeople.
Mm-hmm.
If people really want to be fitted to a proper seat or saddle, I recommend look for a saddle ergonomist or an equine ergonomist. Ergonomist comes out of the Greek word and means something three-dimensional measured.
Mm-hmm.
Like if your office chair is three-dimensional, it's ergonomically designed.
Okay.
The horse's back is three-dimensional, the saddle, the rider's bed, bottom. So if you think about that, we have this academy in Australia, in Europe, in North America. We are just opened in South America. And what we do there is we certify people. So what I recommend,
mm-hmm,
look for saddle ergonomist or for equine ergonomist. You can find them, Google them, you go on the website Saddle Fit for Life. People ask me all the time, why do you give all the secrets away? Because there is a lot of horses, 9.6 million horses in North America. I have a market share of 0.9%.
Mm-hmm.
I don't like to sell something what I can't service.
Yeah.
But I see a lot of horses in need and a lot of people in need. That's why we have opened this school. This is why we teach this.
Yeah.
And you met Terry Piper. She's one of the earliest certified saddle ergonomist. She's able to not just fit you, also to measure,
mm-hmm,
the horse. And while the horse changes, change the saddle, or you get another horse, take that saddle and bring it to another horse.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
Okay. Again, thank you very much.
Thank you kindly. Thanks for having me.